All right, well, this is Wednesday, August 17th, 2016, and we've been doing a little excavation in the rain. You can see the regularity of the slope of this large stone, and this stone is one piece all the way down. So the dirt was there at that level, and it's just where the moss is where the dirt was. So the dirt came right up to the edge of that moss. So I've dug down about 3 feet in some places, but all of this is one piece. So this is attached to this, is attached to that, is attached to that. It's one piece. So there's a little bit of a gap there, straight line seam, but then down here it all comes together. So it's all one piece, but I'm getting down to where I want to be. There may or may not be a tunnel entrance here, but this seems to be talking about something. This stone feature which curves around, over there there's a piece of it. I think it's going to be one large stone piece, and it feels to me that somewhere in here there's going to be a tunnel entrance. Because this is a rarity here in this hill, which is largely glina, largely clay, here in central Serbia. And you don't see any stone features anywhere, and then suddenly there's this huge massive feature. Here we've been getting lots and lots of stones just like this, and the reason I'm excited about the level we're at here is because right here is where the stones stop and it starts to be clay or really packed earth. So it's really, really strong packed earth below the what I think of as a fill-in stone material. In other words, I feel like the ancients dug the tunnel, then came back later, before the Dark Ages, when they knew that barbarism was going to take over the planet, and they filled in the tunnel entrance, just like they filled in tunnel entrances all over the world. They filled in Göbekli Tepe in Turkey. So they used this stone, very, very tightly packed stone pile. And then, but below that, to keep animals from digging in and finding the tunnel, to keep people from digging in, super strong, little by little, if you have the right tools, you can dig these stones out. And then below that is super strong earth. So I feel like just a little further down, if there is a tunnel entrance, it'll be just below where we are now. You can see this kind of rippling effect. There's a rippling there. There's rippling here. Reminiscent of the texturing of the stones on the features in the Bosnian Pyramid Complex, because there's all sorts of stone terraces there, and the tops of them are textured, the bottoms are flat. The tops of the adhered baked clay layers that compose the Fojnica River that runs through the Bosnian Pyramid Complex are also textured. So the features there in Bosnia are tied together at the riverbed. So the water can't get under. So the water is going on top of a built structure, which is the riverbed. So out here in Serbia, it's not too far away. We didn't have Bosnia and Serbia in ancient times, so I feel like this is the same kind of structure, the same kind of material that you can find in the Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun, for instance. There's different materials there. There's concrete, there's sandstone, claystone, pure clay. But here, this is similar to really, really strong, what I feel is baked material adhered with clay, with heated clay. Now, why they would make this one piece stone material here, I don't know, this stone feature here, unknown. But it's getting late in the day, and there's still clouds from the rainstorm, so I'm gonna head out. It's been quite a day. A lot of fun to dig in the rain, and also once the rain stopped, a lot of fun to dig when it wasn't raining. And so just one more look here. I'm going to get some photos, and we are going to continue the search for a tunnel. I'll give you a wide shot of the situation here. Here in Babe, Serbia, just about a kilometer from the Country Club Hotel here in central Serbia, near Sopot, north of Kosmaj.
Have a scientific day.